Permanente Medical Group, a part of Kaiser Permanente. So this is another interesting one. So like every customer in those days and even now to a great extent, they had some mainframe system that did all kinds of appointments and customer engagement stuff, that, but you had to call in, et cetera, to get things done. And they were starting off on creating, digital transforming themselves, really. Start back in 2006, I think, is when we started working with TPMG. And they discovered us through the web, searched, and somehow found that we had this ESB stuff, and contacted us and invited us for there was a guy in the team, he's not here right now, but we have the key person who led the work at the time. And we had a interesting technical evaluation. We actually had to do a bake-off. There's a one-week bake-off with two or three of our competitors, and IBM was one of them as well, and another company, I remember. We flew in two of our technical guys, and we had to implement like 10 different scenarios for them to kind of show that this thing could do what they wanted it to do. And we finished that, I think in like two or three days, we had finished everything. The other guys had like six people working on for 2 weeks or whatever to finish that stuff. So that was pretty impressive for them, and they started working with us. And it was the first time we had written some code that was actually interacting directly with the mainframe from the ESB and doing a bunch of things. So it was a complicated thing because mainframes have their own personality and characteristics and objectives in life, and they don't quite align with a little bit of open source code usually. But it was really fun, and it was another one of these things that helped us evolve the platform significantly. And since then, they've grown to being one of our larger customers. They do lots of different things with us, not just ESP anymore. And we really appreciate one of the key things that really booted us up from bottom up was the customer reference as well. And I forgot to mention that for eBay, eBay's been a willing spokesperson for WSO2. They've given multiple talks at conferences. And the same thing with TPMG. It's been awesome to get that going. So again, thank you very much for the trust at the early days. And I'd like to invite Jay, who actually was the director of the team at the time when they selected us and did the evaluation, and wouldn't be here if not for you guys. So thank you.
Hi there. So I think it's been 10 years, so I sort of remember what happened and what Sanjiva was describing. The department was new at that time, and I was just recently hired as a director. We were, I think, five of us, if I'm not mistaken. The IBM team were 10 people. It was really good to see how three people, including, I think, Sanjiva, you were also there, if I'm not mistaken. So he and two engineers worked it out, solved like half of our problems at that time. But we are now 300 people department, and we exclusively use WSO2 as our SOA architecture. Now we're talking about microservices and how we can use them. So they have grown with us, and we could see the maturity of the company, the product line, but it goes back to what Ron was saying, the deep depth in technology. It's not so much selling. They don't sell things, I've noticed that. So we really like that. We work like that. We work like a startup within a large organization, and they have supported us really well. And I'm grateful to see that you're going to support four students for their education. That's great. So thank you, and congratulations.
Thank you very much.